start by picking up on the Paris Agreement that has been referred to already. This was a major breakthrough agreement, as you all know, last December, which basically sets the tone, along with the 17 SDGs, for the next 15 years. One of the major outcomes of the Paris Agreement was to agree on a long-term temperature goal. The mitigators, the people who are working on lowering emissions, have to deliver the 1.5 long-term temperature goal. We, who are the adapters, who are trying to adapt to the increases in temperature, our motto is hope for the best, but prepare for the worst. So we hope that they will achieve 1.5, but we have to be ready to go to 2 degrees and perhaps even higher. And that's happening now, and we have urgency here. And there are 3 points I'll make. The first one is that adaptation now, investment and activities on adaptation 2016 onwards, post Paris, is not a short-term phenomenon anymore. So thinking of it in short-term projects that will deliver adaptation is no longer a viable paradigm. So you need to think of short-term investments. They may be 3 or 5 year investments, but they must leave a long-term dividend. They are investments in the long term. And what matters is what you leave behind, not what you do during a project period. And that really is a very critical distinction between what we've seen so far and what we need to think about in the future. So investing in the long term. The second corollary of that is that if you start thinking about investing in the long term, you have to think about the next generation. The young people of today are the ones that we need to make aware to start with, but then knowledgeable and capable in the future, as Professor Watanabe said. So embedding the knowledge systems for adaptation within the knowledge training systems of a country, universities, schools, the next generation need to be invested in. And the third point I'll make is a normative point. In my view, any investments on adaptation have to be biased in favor of the most vulnerable. If you're not thinking about the most vulnerable, then you're not doing it right. You need to think, whatever your investment is, how is this going to affect the most vulnerable communities, people, gender, women, disabled, young people. You have to disaggregate the most vulnerable, and you have to think about them and how the investments are going to help them. Or in some cases, there have been adaptation investments which have actually harmed the most vulnerable because it was not thought of in terms of what's going to happen to them. So that now is no longer acceptable. For an adaptation to climate change investment, you do need to think about what the impact is going to be on the most vulnerable, and hopefully incorporate positive impacts and support for the most vulnerable as a result of the investments that you make. So with that, let me ask all of you to thank our panelists for an excellent start to the 3 days of their forum. Thank you all very much.